just too bitter for words, don't wanna taste it. That's just too bitter for words, don't wanna face it. But I think that I'm done tripping, I'm tripping. I've been sipping, that's how I control this feeling you keep giving, you keep on getting it, ooh, oh. Maybe it's your love, it's too good to be true. Baby boy, your love got me tripping on you. You know your love is big enough, made me trip on you. Yeah, it's big enough, got me tripping on you.
You are watching Find Your Grind Live. We have a really great guest today, Valentina. Stay tuned. I'm gonna play some more music. Let's hang out and have fun.
Black leather glove, no sequin. Buckles on the jacket, it's elite. Nike crossbody got a piece in it. Gotta dance, but it's really on some street. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you the passion. It's a thriller in a trap. Where we from? Baby, don't you wanna dance with me? You know, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could get you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we bout to slide. Hey, can't let this one slide. Hey. Don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you the passion. It's a thriller in a trap. Where we from? Baby, don't you wanna dance with me? No, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide.
Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide.
Maybe this will finally be the summer that we fall in love. Memories and forms of Polaroids and catching lightning buzz. I could bring some drinks and things and maybe we can catch a buzz. I hope we fall in love, yeah, we gon' fall in love, yeah. I hope we fall in love, yeah, we gon' fall in love, yeah, yeah. I hope we fall in love. It's your in the summer, baby. Let me make a cameo. Surfing on your way forever, all the way from Mexico. Señorita muy bonita, acting like a Scorpio. Hope you know that you gon' fall for me, just like the domino. Bulls out with coronas, no liking. Persona, you're a rider, and Winona. Ever leave me alone. I said, tell your friends to call their friends tonight. They gon' be friends of mine. Dancing to this mic like a. I said, now baby, this gon' finally be the summer that we fall in love. Memories and fools of polar bears and catching lightning bugs. I can bring some drinks and things and maybe we can catch a buzz. I hope we fall in love now. Now we gon' fall in love now, baby. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I hope we fall in love. Yeah, we fall in love. I hope we fall in love. Yeah, we say summer. Summer time, we say summer, summertime, yeah, yeah, yeah. Summer. I feel like summer.
That's sound effects, by the way. That's what that was.
Happy Monday, y'all. Welcome to FIG Live, 20 minutes of insights and inspiration for students, educators, and parents. I'm Charlie Kane, one of the content producers here at Find Your Grind, and with me is the vibe curator herself, the one and only Kayleen.
Yes. That's a good one, Charlie. I really like vibe curator. Taking that, stealing that, putting that.
Like that? Yeah. I was going to switch it with like 70s, summery, spring, vibe.
I went with the summer. It's not summer yet, but it feels like summer. That's why I went with that. Because it feels like summer. It's confusing.
Lucky, because here it's overcast and raining. But that's cool. Sending all the warm vibes to y'all today. Tell us, Kayleen, what are we in for today?
Okay, like I said, today our guest is an amazing, beautiful woman inside and out, and I've only hung out with her for the past 30 minutes. So if I'm already getting that, that means it's real. Today's guest is a social media strategist and manager who not only helps other brands with their socials, but she also produces content. One woman manages her own branded platforms. Through her work, she's been able to lock in a lot of influencer and brand partnerships like Foot Locker, Smashbox Cosmetics, and Nike. And again, while establishing her own brand and her own creation, everyone, please give it up for my friend, Valentina.
So good. Let me just why we're talking to Valentina today. Because of our current realities, we've been thrown into studying, working, and playing in this digital space. And I'm sure a lot of boundaries have been blurred since. A lot of you are probably starting your messages with hope you're safe and healthy, or just a lot of undefined areas when it comes to how to communicate or ask things for one another. I know for me personally, dissecting messages from punctuation, being left on read, or one word answers throw me in a loop. So today we're going to talk about how to network in this digital space appropriately and effectively. Thank you, Valentina, for joining us today.
Of course, thank you so much, Kayleen and Charlie, for having me. I'm so excited for this.
Yeah, let's dive right into it. Tell us more about what you do and how you got to what you're doing today.
Totally. To bring it a few years back, I went to school specifically for communications, and at that time I was studying public relations. Something that I never thought in the world would kind of merge with digital media. And I basically have a strong background in public relations, and I came through 4 years after my national public relations studying that I did. And it was probably one of the best things that I ever did, because again, just merging that public relations with digital media, it really gave for the rise of what I do today, what I do for brands versus what I do for my personal brand. And it's been a really interesting kind of melting pot of how everything has kind of come together. It's been fishing all of my PR skills, all of my experience in that area, and then kind of merging it with everything that I learned on site as myself being a digital manager, and then also working in an agency where I was a social media strategist, a social media account coordinator, and basically was wearing many hats that I was able to take with me and then apply it to the successes that I have today.
Jeez, that's a lot.
It's a lot.
All I keep hearing is the word social. So, I mean, I think people already have some kind of sense of what it means to be social, or like what personality or what personal characteristics you have to have when you're social. So what are things in your personality that allows you to network so easily?
Yeah, it was such a learning curve, definitely trial and error, but I think one of the greatest things that some people may not think of when it comes to networking socially is the ability to listen. And I feel like it's such a quality that people oversee, because of course you're networking, you're talking, you're constantly just looking for the next thing to do. But one of the things I feel like makes me such a great networker person is listening. You definitely want to make sure you're listening to what the person you're networking is saying, because it'll allow you to kind of latch onto that conversation.
How are you able to apply?
So allows you to establish that.
Sorry, keep going. What were you saying?
No, you're fine. Listening and making sure you're grabbing onto something that you probably want to like piggyback off after you're done talking with them. Just kind of shows for like an organic conversation, and you know, it fosters that real relationship with the person you're networking with.
How are you able to, I guess, listen when it is in the digital space where it's not exactly like you can hear, but it's more off of like text communication?
That's such a good question, and it's definitely something that me myself have tried to find, again, that trial and error in it. What I've done is really just canceling all of the outside distractions that are going on right now, and just because there is so much time in our day. To really focus in on what it is that you're reading or probably listening to or just really trying to digest. So that's probably my best advice that I can give, is really just canceling anything that you can around you, since you're not really at a loud event or at a loud networking space. You're really just probably in the comfort of your own home or in a quiet space per se. So while it can drive some people crazy of just quiet noise, it helps to just kind of cancel what's around you and just really hone in on what it is that you're focusing or trying to network with.
Yeah, I think that's really important, because I think we are living in a world that is instantaneous and people want answers like right away. And sometimes when you're communicating like that, you're not exactly reading everything, or in that sense, listening to everything that person is saying. And we're just like replying back and not like reading everything thoroughly. So I have to remind myself to get into that like quiet space in my head, or almost like entering in a different room to like text back, or like not multitask while I'm texting something back. That definitely helps. But it's funny to think that you have to go into these like pockets, like mind pockets, to remove yourself to enter the digital space.
No, absolutely. It's so interesting, because especially now, like I coming from a place where I have to be on my phone, then on my computer, then also talking to someone at the same time. Now it's kind of like I'm just on my computer. If I'm going to talk to my cat, yeah, sure, but I'm not really talking to anyone else. So I have all that undivided attention that I can give something. So it's a great kind of
I didn't catch that last part. Can you say that one more time?
Yeah, I said that I think it's a great practice in play, so that all of that undivided attention that we have right now, to just give it to what it is that you're doing, whether it's networking, reading something, listening to anything, rereading something. We have the time to do it, so why not?
I like that. Yeah, that's good. Yeah. To stay present and give it 100% of yourself. Yeah. You know, I think there's also some, like, I guess, I wouldn't say stereotypes, but maybe stereotypes of if you are, like, a social media personality or a social media influencer or just good at social media, that you have to be an extrovert. But I feel like social media in general kind of evens out the playing field. So do you... what do you feel like there are things about social media that can allow anyone to network?
I think it really, it creates or kind of breaks that third wall, I guess, if that makes sense, where people are now behind this device where you're not really, there's a lot that comes into play with physical interaction, body language, just how the person feels, if you're picking up on some kind of like sign from someone else. I feel like social media really cuts out that middle thing that's going on. I don't know the right word for it is, but social media allows for, if you're an introvert, extrovert, to kind of just be who it is that you want to be. Don't quote me on the statistics, but there are a lot of introverts out there that lead very successful, quiet, shy, really weird words that are kind of given to them just because of the way that they act. But little do you know, they probably lead a very successful online life just because people have different ways of kind of unraveling in how they go about things.
Yeah, I do want to touch up on that because I used to work for a company and I would host like influencer events. And you're right, like you can have a very successful social media personality and own your brand without having to be an extrovert. And it was so fascinating to me that I would meet these amazing big name influencers, but they didn't talk, like they were not the same person in real life. How have you developed your personality so that you are, I mean, just as the same as you are behind the lens or like in front of people? Your personality is like, it shows either way. So how have you been able to develop yourself?
Yeah, that's such a good question because I get it very often. And people are really surprised when they find out that I was already working in social media or public relations before it. So it wasn't that much of a shift forward. It was just more of, okay, I'm the brand now or I'm the face now instead of this beauty product or this other brand that I'm pushing. So it was kind of like a diamond, I guess. Transition. It wasn't really anything that developed over time. It was just kind of like the same thing, just something else that I was dealing with. But in terms of how it's developing further now and adapting to the way the realm is changing, it definitely is different for me. I don't because I'm just developing with it as it goes. Like TikTok blew up overnight and I felt like I needed to read a manual on how to use TikTok. Like that was the scariest thing. And I just feel like that's where my development is. It isn't so much in my personality because like you said, it just kind of shows the same as it does when I was a agency worker or doing this before I actually became like an influencer or a brand separately. The development was there. It was the same. Now it's just more developing with the new gadgets that are out or the new like updates that are out. It's more developing in that area.
Would you have any advice though for like students or the youth who want to be a social media influencer?
Mm-hmm.
But you know, I think it's just as important to know how to talk to brand partner or to brands for partnerships, go to interviews, or even just like keep up with friends. Like, do you have any like top advice for them and how to develop that personality?
Yeah, absolutely. One of the things I definitely learned in my first runs of doing this is really finding what's the most personal to you, because that's what's going to have you stand out from your best friend, a stranger, anyone that you're looking to either network with or meet or just get into a conversation with. It'll definitely allow you to really identify what it is that you bring to the table and have that conversation create itself through that. The only reason I say that is because when I was kind of blossoming into this influencer world, there is a lot of beauty brands and it's so saturated, and you kind of take a step back and think, what can I offer this space that already has so much that it's stealing? So my advice is that when you're really finding and developing that personality, seeing what it is that you can bring to a brand that's unique and how it'll start a different conversation of something that they don't already have going on. And it's worked for me countless times whenever you're really pitching yourself in that kind of light of what it is that you can bring to this brand, why they should look at you, why they should even bother to work with you or give you the time of day and spend the money on you to really share your voice and have it merge with the brand voice and communicate that to your audience.
Yeah. And once you do make it personal and, like, make it authentically you, it shows your passion. So I feel like being passionate about what you want to be doing easily will shine through in your personality or how you're talking or, like, what you want to be, like, showcasing. Okay, so I want to get...
100%.
I want to get into, like, the thick of things when it comes to... social media or using social media network, how do you slide in someone's DMs for partnerships or collabs? Like, what is the correct way to do it?
I get this question asked so many times by, like, friends or just followers that really want to, you know, get into the business of doing this. And there is a secret to it. Obviously I'm going to share it with you because that's what we're here for.
If you just said like, no, I'm not sharing. There's a secret, but you have to figure that one out on your own.
You have to follow me on social media. That's a secret.
Yeah. You have to DM me.
Like clickbait.
You have to slide in my DMs to find out what that secret is.
That'd be great. That'd be good.
Nobody, it's a lot of people get really frightened or just kind of insecure, I would say, just because that's how I thought. I was like, why would a brand with 12 million followers even care about looking at someone who barely has like $2,000 or whatever? And the secret in that is, again, it goes back to like really stating that statement of what it is that you bring to the table. And yes, it is sliding into a DM, introducing yourself, who you are, what you represent, what you're here for. And one of the things that I took with me from my PR background is that consistent following up aspect. I'm so huge into following up all the time. A lot of people don't believe in it because they don't want to be a pest. They don't want to bother. They feel like if they didn't look at it the first time, why would they look at it the second time? But because I come... You'd be surprised how many emails to a spam folder don't get read, just kind of get moved. So it's just having that confidence and consistency with yourself and just knowing like, okay, the brand didn't get back to me a few months ago, let me follow up again. Like, it really does not hurt. And there is a science to it. And I feel like that's my science to it, is like pitching yourself, putting yourself out there. And if, you know, brands work with budgets on a quarter basis, and I know that's kind of my PR talk coming in, but it's so second nature to me to think of it from a logistical perspective that when I'm trying to kind of filter it to a person who probably has absolutely no idea what any of these quarters or budgets are, I would just go back to saying, slide into the DM, follow up, because if you truly care about something and truly want to work with a brand, that's where the And I promise you
I have three questions there. So one, in your pitch, is that just like three sentences? Like, hi, my name is Valentina, I'm this, and then kind of like your authentic place. Is that like three sentences?
So it's more like a ABCD that I usually outline when I help people with how they pitch themselves. So it's an introduction, who you are, what's your handle, where the brand can find you, what it is that you feel like you can bring to the table that aligns with the brand voice, and then attaching back where you can contact me at whenever I'm available, if you'd like to chat, kind of having that nice little closing off statement, but still leaving it open and putting the ball in the brand's court.
And is this usually an email or is this a DM?
So I like to do both. Any with the brand or not, like, it's work. It's literally, you're working for yourself. It's a DM that you're doing, and then you're also following up through an email. An email, I feel like you have much more range with that, because if you have a media kit or a website you want to insert or just something you want to attach, it allows you to also include that into a body of work.
And how many times are you hitting them up with a follow-up? Is it once, twice, three times a charm?
So I have a two-email follow-up rule. you send the one, which is kind of like, hey, what's up? Like, I'm like your first pitch email. And then just your second one where you're kind of like, hey, what's up again? Like, checking in, hope you saw like my first email. And then just kind of reinstating yourself and saying why it is that you really collaboration can happen.
Yeah. And then how many followers did you have when you started doing this formula?
I was like at 1,000.
Wow.
Literally, like at 1,000.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
And how many do you have? How many followers do you have right now?
I'm at 27. I just hit the 27K mark last week, finally.
Don't add applause, Kaylee.
Getting there.
All right. So, okay. I'm sure you've reached out to a lot of brands for like collaborations or partnerships or features for. But I'm sure as you have done social media for other brands, what are messages that you would say yes to, and what are messages that you'd be like, that's okay, no thanks?
So it really helps once you reach a certain point of what you know what you want, you know what's your personal, you know what's your unique, you know what your audience is, what really gets your ball rolling. I'm very much into the sustainable, eco-friendly aspect of my engagement right now. So just flat and simple, there's a lot of things that I say no to because I know they don't have an ethical or moral background in the type of business that they do that match what it is that I'm talking to my audience about. An audience is very, very into looking at the transparency of how the person is speaking about their brand. So I've kind of reached that point where if a brand reaches out and I see that they're not really what it is that I'm preaching about on my because then I have to explain to my audience why I'm working with a brand that doesn't really stand for what I stand for. And then I think the opposite of that, saying yes, is to the brands that I would align with what I'm preaching for, advocating for on my platform.
Yeah. I like that because it's more so the more you do it, I think the more you understand your values, understand what your authentic voice is, and you're just trying to protect that even more or use that to really advocate for what your brand or platform is about. So it's really, yeah, again, honing in on understanding your values, what you bring out, your strengths. So that's really awesome. I never thought about social media, like being able to do that, to like really like have you focus.
And don't get me wrong, it's a lot of trial and error. Like you have to definitely say yes to something. You're at a point where you're just like, yeah, let me try it out. I've never done anything like this before. But once you see it and you do it, you learn from it. Do you want to do something like that again? You're now in the position where you can choose now.
Yeah,
that is the whole thing with Find Your Grind. It's all like self-discovery. Whether you're self-discovering in social media, you're pretty much figuring out what your voice is, again, your strengths and values, and then you're able to establish more and more like what opportunities to say yes to. But at the beginning, you just say yes, you just try, and you just like go for it.
Wow, yeah.
So cool. I learned a lot today about social media.
Well, and that's what I think a lot of people, I mean, I think most of the young people in high school, that's how they're getting laws passed. And that's how people are actually making social change from social media or federal change or global change or whatever, state change. Like people are actually, the young people are showing us that you can do that from your social media. It's cool that you focused in, you're using that, you're using your skills and your talents and your audience and your partnerships to do that though, because I was wondering like when you, because you said you have to say yes to some things, but then you, because you have to or you need to, but then later on you can kind of say, okay, I want to align with this for this reason. Like, did you, is there a certain, do you remember a certain moment or did something go wrong, or when were you like, okay, I need to start focusing on, I want to put my foot down and only do things that I want to do? You know, like, how did that happen? Is it a gradual thing? Because I'd love to go, I only want to work with this type of audience or these people, but, like, you can't right now because you're trying to make money or you're trying to survive, right? You know, like, how did you decide that?
I think I had never listened to my body, a teenager or even a young adult or early 20 adults, because you just want to say yes to everything because you have the energy for it. So why spend your time saying no? But then when you listen to your body and your exhaustion levels, you're just like, wait, I can now start filtering things out of whether they're paying me or not, of what I want to say yes to, because I know it takes X amount of time to do this, and then it'll take X amount of time to see the return value on something that I'm giving my 100% to. There were many times where I was giving 30% of myself to something, and then the return would be like 5%, and I'm like, are you kidding me? Like, why do I feel so burnt out over something? And it, in the end, it just didn't make any more sense. It was just like, I either give 100% to something, if it has a great return, great, instead of giving my best and then claiming a tantrum for absolutely no reason when I'm all too much energy, and it's like, it's not good in the end.
Yeah. So your body physically was like, okay, because that I ran into that last summer. So I think I'm like understanding it and learning it and trying to like pick up on how do you, but again, you don't think about that. And I'm in my early 20s, like I don't think you think about that until like something goes wrong. So it's like, it's like when your parents like, don't touch that, and then you touch it anyway and you burn yourself. It's like, you don't do anything until you learn, but it stinks that you have to like, sometimes you have to burn out to understand, okay, this is my point. But I think that just also comes with like freelancing. Yeah. You're like, I'm my own person, so I've got to do this on my own. But yeah. That's interesting. I'm definitely going to take what you said and remember that. I wanted to ask, when it comes to like networking, how do you like, you talk about following up, but how do you, I remember reading in a book once about networking book. If I had the book, I'd plug it right here, but I don't. But it was said that like, thank you was then like the number one thing that happens with networking, and the relationship is like, relationship building is networking. But what do you like, how long do you, or what is your thoughts, or what is your relationship with like building a relationship with people and like thanking them? Like, what is your mindset when it comes to like the, okay, you did the reach out, you did the ABC method, you know, you did the two email thing, you got the gig, you did the thing, you put your 100% in, and then now you're finished and you say like, what's the after thing? Cause like, you could have another thing after that, or like, what's your post project when it comes to networking, what's your strategy?
Really, especially in the certain climate that we're in now, a lot of the times when these projects finish, I just, again, implementing that background that I have of following up, my public relations background of checking in, really establishing a real relationship with these brands or these people that work for these brands, is because one, they're human. Two, it doesn't hurt to send an email saying, hey, how are you doing? Hope everything's well. And just checking in, like, is there anything that I can bring to the table during this time of working with you again, or maybe just helping out on a campaign that doesn't necessarily need to include me, but I can help you find any talent it is that you're looking for during that time. To bring it back to why right now is such an important moment to follow. And people that I'm just emailing them just to check in and making sure that they're okay. And not because it takes time out of my day or because I have the extra time to do it, but it's because we're all human and really going through something right now. And believe it or not, these things stick with these people because you're establishing a real relationship. You're not just talking to them because it's a brand that you're working with and they're paying you. No, it's you still want to build a relationship because you do meet these people face to face when events come around or whenever someone's in town or anything like that. Like, it's really nice to create that post campaign like relationship.
Yeah. I think that's the, I didn't even think about right now going, oh, hey, how are you doing this time? What can I do just as a human? I like it because I'm a big, like, let's talk to people and let's treat people like they're human and let's keep that in there. So I really like that. You have a lot of good little nuggets in here. I'm like, I don't know. You should definitely write a book if you're not writing a book already. The like consistency, your ABCD method, your two email thing. Like, you if it's not a book, it's a blog. If it's not a blog, it's a YouTube video. I don't know what it is, but you definitely got like a structure or like, cause, and I think too, you think logistically, but then also like with your heart at the same time. And I think that's hard to come by a lot of the time with someone who's like, hey, everyone, welcome this social influencer. Like, that's pretty rare. So I think this is very interesting and very fun. Not really.
Thank you.
Yeah, I feel like what you've been communicating all this long is that it's like a two-way street. Like, it's not a one-way. Mm-hmm. It's not the brand using you. It's not you trying to get money from a brand or you trying to get featured. But it is like, it's a two-way exchange, you know? And I think the importance of that is like, not just following up, but also expressing your like gratitude for that partnership, whether it was just a one-time thing or like you're trying to build a partnership. I think these days especially, it's good to express gratitude with the opportunities that you're given, you know?
Yes, totally.
So there's one more question that we ask all our mentors, and it is, what does find your grind mean to you?
Oh, yeah. I think find your grind to me means find, like, your adaptability, if that makes sense. I'm from New York City, raised here. I feel like the type of, like, hustle environment. I told my boyfriend about this the other day, and find your grind to me just means finding your adaptability and being consistent. And this has so much to do with what's going on right now, because you just never know what will happen, as cliche as that sounds. So being able to adapt to the consistent grind is what will allow you to just continue to propel forward and not really get so caught up in the why or who's or this and that. It's just adapting your analyzing and aware of the situation, but you're adapting to it and moving forward. So that's what I feel like that means to me.
Awesome. A lot of self-awareness practices,
yes,
right there, for sure. Awesome. Valentina, where can everyone find you? How can we find your future book, your future blog, your future YouTube, and all
for real
this? How do we find that?
Yeah, totally. So I'm mainly on Instagram at Sunflower Valentine, and then I do have a link in my bio there where I have a YouTube channel and I have my blog situation going on, which has some updates that I need to do it, but everything is there. Everything is on my Instagram channel and you can find me there.
Awesome. Such a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you so much for
amazing
advice, your background, just like a lot of things that I have to think about when it comes to social media too. So been amazing. Thank you.
Thank you, ladies.
Yes, thank you. Everyone check out Mondays and Fridays. We're doing more Twitch hangs. We're sitting down with real people talking about real things. Their real brains, their real hearts, kind of like Valentina today. So tune in on Mondays and Fridays on Twitch. And then we're going to do some mini workshops, mini lessons with different guests that are focusing on things like cameras and drawing and self-love and everything in between all that. So check out the mini workshops and lessons. And then Wednesdays, of course, we're going to be doing educator-parent roundtable with the squad, the dream team, the learning trifecta. That's happening over there. So go check out the educator stuff. And then Charlie, where can everyone discover their own networking skills and self-discovery things.
If you're trying to network with us and build with us, make sure to check us out on all your favorite social media platforms at Find Your Grind. Make sure you, if you miss any Twitch episodes that we've done, they're all listed in our videos. And visit findyourgrind.com to begin your self-discovery and career exploration journey now, or learn more about our mentors like Valentina. So that's our episode for today. Again, thank you, Valentina, for being an amazing guest and giving us a dish on how to slide into the DMs. I'm Charlie Kane with Valentina and Kayleen, and we're out.
I dance with grace, release the pain, and write the grace under the trees. I dance with grace, release my pain, and na 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 na.
Like this.